In this video, we're going to take a look at creating line-based elements. In other words, elements that are created by sketching lines. So we're going to take a look at an architecture example, a structure example, and then some MEP examples. So right now I have a project open that was created using the default architectural template. And I'll activate the wall tool from the architecture ribbon in the build panel. When I do, you can see that the ribbon changes and there is a draw gallery available. So there are actually several draw tools that I can use. And so for this example, we're going to focus on the line tool. And when I move the cursor into the drawing area, you can see the tooltip as well as the status bar says click to enter wall start point. So when I click, I can then see a preview of the wall. And there are also listening dimensions. So those are the dimensions that adjust as you move the cursor. And you can see an angle as well as a length dimension. And then when the cursor is horizontal to the starting point, a tooltip will appear that says horizontal. And when it's vertical, a tooltip will say vertical. And so that can help you as you are creating a wall. So I can then simply click again to place the ending point. And when I do, you can see that another wall segment is beginning now. And the reason is because chain is selected in the options bar. So when chain is selected, you can then click again to place another wall. So I'll create a wall at a 45 degree angle. And now you can see that the walls are connected. Next, I'm going to move the cursor straight down, vertical, and then I'm going to type 10 and press enter. And what happened there is I created a wall 10 feet long, because the units in this project are feet and fractional inches. I'll do one more here. So I'm going to move the cursor to the left. And then I'm going to type 25 space 6 and press enter. And what happened there is I created a wall 25 feet 6 inches in length. So with feet and fractional inches, you can type feet, press space, and then enter, and then type the inches and press enter. So feet, space, inches, and press enter, and Revit will input the feet and inches for you. So you don't have to worry about trying to type any additional formatting in there. All right, I'm gonna press escape once and I end that current segment. And then I can click again to place another wall segment. And so with chain selected, once again, the ending point of the first segment will be the starting point of the next. When chain is deselected, you can then simply click 2 points and place a wall, and another wall segment will not be created. You can press escape again to end the tool, press escape again to end the tool, or you can simply click modify. So, once again, line-based elements, you simply click a start point and an end point. Now I'm going to switch over to another project, and this was created using the default structural template. And I'll switch to the structure ribbon, and in the structure panel, I'll click beam to activate the structural framing beam tool. Once again, there is a draw gallery in the contextual ribbon. And we'll focus on line for now. And I'm going to leave chain deselected. And once again, I can click 2 points to place a beam. Now, I will select chain and we'll take a look at what happens when we create a chain of beams, if you will. So I'll move at a 45 degree angle. Then I'll move down and click again. And then I'll press escape a couple times to end the command. This time you can see that, or at least right now, we are in the coarse level of detail. So the beams appear a little bit differently. And they appear that they are not connected, but that's just the way beams work, they are cut back from each other. But continuing on, another little tip here, when you hover over a chain of objects and press tab, they will all highlight, and then you can click to select the chain of connected elements. I'm going to switch to the fine level of detail, and now you can see what we have here. Just by creating a chain of beams here, you can see the outcome. And so that may or may not be what you want to create. And so just be aware of when you're using chain and how that works. So you can see the beams here. I'll switch back to the walls. You can see they have a little bit different way of connecting there. All right. Now let's switch to the MEP project. And this was created using the default systems template. And I'll switch to the systems ribbon. And in the HVAC panel, I'll click duct. And this time there is not a draw gallery. And ductwork, piping, conduit, cable trays, you simply sketch lines. Click 2 points to create a line, and the element will be created along that line. So I'm going to begin clicking points. And you'll notice there's also not a chain option. So with MEP elements, it's the default. And as I sketch lines, you can see that the ductwork is being created, a duct along each line. And there's also a fitting that is being placed in between each connected segment. And that is the way MEP elements work. There are fittings that connect the elements. So it's a little bit different than walls and beams. And I'm going to click modify to end the command and then start the pipe tool. And once again, I can move the cursor at different angles. I can type in a specific distance. It's all the same. It just, there's different elements being created along those lines. And then once again, with MEP elements, we have fittings that are being placed in between each segment. Once again, I can hover over an element, press tab to highlight the chain of elements. All right, so that's the basics of creating line-based elements. And I'll wrap up with covering something that I didn't touch on to begin with that's also important when you're creating line-based elements. But when I activate the wall tool, you can see that there's a base constraint, a base offset, and then there's a top constraint parameter, and then an unconnected height, depending on what this is. And so you want to make sure that when you're creating walls, you adjust the bottom and top. And then similarly, when I go back and activate the beam tool, there are Y offset and Z offset values. And there's several parameters with beams, but you have start and end extensions, and so that doesn't necessarily control any offset, that controls the extension at the start and end points. But you definitely want to pay attention to the Z offset value, which can be your essentially the height of the beam. And then lastly, we'll come back here, activate the duct tool again, and you can see that there's a reference level, and then there's top, middle, and bottom elevation parameters that you can use to set the height. So in summary, it's really pretty simple. You're just sketching lines, and then the line-based element is created along that line, and it's created at the height or using the bottom and top offsets, depending on what type of element it is.
Howdy! Thanks for watching. If you'd like more free content from Click to BIM, please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We also have affordable subscription options at click2bim.com, where you can access all of our videos. We also have an amazing search feature that allows you to search through every single word in all of our videos to help you quickly find the answers to your questions.